All right, welcome again to Military Guna TV. Thank you very much for tuning in. And this today we're going to speak about deployment tactical, the Brigade Boy tactical insight, and how we might see future deployments, and also what previously happened in our last three match friendlies. Now, we've heard news about upcoming friendlies, also the squad to be released, and we're still anticipating and pending those dates, and definitely also anticipating the squad list. Now, we as fans are no concern in regards to the tactical aspect of things. For me, I am concerned about the tactical aspect of things, because this is a part of the football game that I love to discuss and I love to go on about. I might be wrong. I won't say my opinion is actually the correct thing. I will not say what I'm saying is the correct thing, but I'm just giving you guys my insight. My insight is on a tactical basis. You guys might disagree. You guys also might agree. You might have people who really lash out on this, and I do think people will lash out on it as well, but I do think that it is my opinion, and it's the way I see going forward. But there are actually facts in it, which are stats coming from our previous three games and things that we have done in our previous three games, and we'll see how well that was deployed. So in our last three appearances, we conceded 8 goals and only scored 3, and that is really, really bad. So we averaged literally scoring 1 goal a game and conceding up to 2 goals per game. 2.5 goals per game. That is not good. On a defensive record, that is not good. Yes, we might bring the argument that it's not our best team, but we can't solely depend on our best team all the time to produce the results. At least some of the time, our worst team should produce some form of result. Even if we don't score, we should keep a relatively good clean sheet. It doesn't matter which time or what time in the game we concede those goals. At the end of the day, the scoreline will state what happened. Now, we could say that the game didn't tell, the scoreline don't tell the full story, and that is obvious. But in the world of football, football is a results business, and at the end of the day, the scoreline is what really mattered. So you concede 8 goals in 3 games, it doesn't matter what the situation is, it's not a good look. You score 3 goals in 3 games, yes, you can say, okay, you score a goal per game, but was that enough for you to win the game? Scoring 3 goals, and we should bear in mind that in one of those games, we scored 2 goals. So literally, we score 1 in the other, and then we conceded a whole bunch of goals. At the end of the day, it just wasn't good enough. Those 3 friendlies that we played was not good enough. 2 against Saudi Arabia, and then now the last one against the USA. The USA, we could say literally, the scoreline didn't necessarily tell the entirety of the game, but at the end of the day, they did whip us, and they whipped us really, really well. Now, this is the reason why I'm doing this show, to give you guys an insight on how we can better ourselves on a tactical level, or we can better a team going forward. What formation can we deploy? What formation has been previously used by Mr. Whitmore himself, and how well this system will be deployed? We know that Jamaica Rugby Boys, we're not a technical-based team, that we dominate possession, but I think that this is the direction that we should move the team towards. But for now, and also the current fixtures that we have coming up, I doubt we'll get that time to instill those type of system for us to get at that base of technicalities. Now, let's move into the first game that we played against Saudi Arabia, where we lost 3-0. That match played on the 14th of November 2020, where we lost that game 3-0. Let me run through that starting lineup, that start on that day, and you guys will get a better understanding. On that day, this is the starting lineup, and also the formation which was deployed on that day was 4-1-4-1, which we have 1 central defensive midfielder, 4 attacking midfielders, and then now 1 striker, which I think is a relatively a balanced formation. But for the players that were deployed, I think it was really, really sad to see. Now, we had in goal Dwayne Miller at right back. We had Greg Lay. We have Kevin Lambert and Damien Lowe sitting as a central defensive pair. And at left back, we have Kemar Taxel-Lawrence. In the defensive midfield position, we have Daniel Johnson holding the line. Over on the right-hand side, we have Kareem Paris, Jashan Anglin, Lamar Walker, and Normal Campbell. Leading line, we had Kamal Malcolm. So it's not the best or the strongest team, I would say, because a lot of these players, we have a few players, Jamaican local players, which weren't playing football throughout that duration. But they did wear the colors, the Jamaican colors, and they did do a sprout despite the result. But for me, that formation for a team that wasn't fully fit and really, really lack a lot of the core players, I think that formation was a wrong formation to use. Reason being, that is an attacking formation, which is an high-stake formation. A high-stake formation where they score a lot of goals or they concede a lot of goals. Now, I come to the consensus that maybe Mr. Whitmore said that let's go out for this game and we see how this one goes. Then for the next game, we can put in proper preparation and see how that one goes. But in all essence, we having Kevin Lambert in a defensive line, I think was a poor choice. We had other defenders on the bench, but definitely, as you know, these guys possibly could not be playing and was not playing sufficient football or insufficient enough football to really, really use it as a cause. So we could also bear in mind that Mr. Whitmore himself also wanted to see what these guys have had to offer, because Michael Ector was on the bench, which we could have slotted in the defensive position as well. So that formation and also those players being deployed could also be a sense in which Mr. Whitmore wanted to see what he has at hand and how he's going to move forward, because it's a friendly and there's no stake at that. But at the end of the day, it could be a friendly, yes or no. You do want to get the best result. You do want to get the best result, because what I do know in football is that winning breeds confidence. And when you have confidence, even your small team, your A, B, C or D team wants to win. And they will give their all, and also they will replicate what the first team is doing and try their best to do that. So when you deploy your first team, set your foundation, and that is the foundation for the first 45 minutes. You'll see how the game is going. Then now you could put in the rest of addition and see how well those players deploy. It makes no sense you start the weaker team, then you integrate the stronger teams. I don't understand that concept. But I do think that he's trying to figure out his team, trial and error. But yes, we have to give a bit of understanding in that aspect. So that was the formation deployed for that game, and we got slapped 3-0. Yes, we did know that we could have done better. I believe we could have done better for that. But let's move now to the next game, which we saw, which we defeated Saudi Arabia. So for the next game that we won, we saw where Mr. Whitmore changing formation from a 4-1-4-1 formation to a 4-2-3-1 formation, which has now solidifying the central midfield area and also the protecting the defense line with two holding midfielders. Now let's go into the formation. Let's go into the system that was deployed, also the players that was deployed as well. On the right-hand side, we have O'Neill Fisher, we had Michael Ector and Damien Lowe at centre-back pairing, and Greg Lee at left-back. In front of them, we have Ravel Morrison and Daniel Johnson, and then now the attacking three over on the right-hand side, we have Liam Bailey, on the left-hand side, Norman Campbell, and then now in the attacking midfield position, we had Bobby Reid. Now up front, leading line, we had Javon East. Now, this time around, we saw where we deployed a bit more of our quality players in the right position. This time now, we saw Mr. Whitmore deploying the right team that he wanted to start initially and also test and adjusting. But I do think that during the time period, it was a really, really close time period to change formation and system. So generally, it was just natural talent that really got us over the line. Now let's move forward now to the latest date of our latest game where we played against the USA. Now for this one, for the game against USA, we deployed in a similar system again, 4-2-3-1. So it is likely to say that this is now the system that Mr. Whitmore will be using going forward. Where we had Jaden White in goal. We had Hadrian Mariappa at right back, Leah Moore and Ethan Pinnock as the centre-back pairing. And over on the left-hand side, we had Amari Bell. The attacking, the two central midfield here, we have Kevon Isaacs and Michael Ector. In front of them, on the right-hand side, we had Ricardo Mars on the right-hand side. In this attacking midfield position, we had Casey Palmer. And over on the left-hand side, the man that scores the lone goal for us, Jamal Lowe. And up front, leading line, new debutant, Andre Gray. Now, as you guys can know, this formation, 4-2-3-1, formation that we deployed in, and it really, really solidified the sense. Now the last two games that we played with this formation, as I said previously, was the Saudi Arabia game where we won the game, and we look a bit more solid with the likes of Daniel Johnson in peak form, also Robin Morrison putting on a great showing, definitely Damien Lowe and Michael Ector looking good as a formidable partnership in that game. But we can see now that we want to improve, we want to get better. We now move on to this current fixture where we saw not much of the core players But we also saw a few new debutants on this day. Now, we can look into it and say that for the next fixtures, run of fixtures for friendlies, we might see a few debutants as well being deployed. But I do believe that Mr. Whitmore should deploy his best team. Then now he can integrate other players, because it is crucial in any football game that you pick up a winning run going to a tournament. It is really, really important. So if you want to pick up a winning run, you play your best players, you start your best players, then now you can integrate the debutants and also the new players in your system. So for me now, let's look into the system that I think Mr. Whitmore should deploy. I believe that the 4-2-3-1 system is a solid system, something that we can definitely look at. But I think that at this point in time, we need to solidify the midfield area and keep it compact and also not vulnerable. Now also we have to consider that our last three games, we conceded 8 goals. We have to work on that as well. Now, how can we move forward? Now, I was looking at the formation 3-5-3-4-3, which I do think can provide an extra element of defensive support for the team, using 2 fullback and 3 defenders. 3 defenders, we could also consider Damien Lowe, Ethan Pinnock, and Liam Moore, Ethan Pinnock over to the left hand side, Damien Lowe in the central, Liam Moore onto the right hand side. We know we can say we have 2 rash tacklers and also 1 cool, calm head person. So we need that balance. That balance is always needed. On the right hand side, we can look at the likes of Wes Harden, who's been deployed so often as a fullback, as a wing back for Tottenham United. But we'll see how that one goes. And over on the left hand side, we know we can see the likes of Taxi as well. In the central midfield area, we need 2 box-to-box midfielder, also 2 persons who are likely to keep the defensive structure as well. But we need physical presence in that area in particular. So I'm looking at players such as Kevin Lambert, Daniel Johnson, and also, if possible, Lewis Baker. But these guys are people who can protect the defense line and keep it solid in front of them. So those are the 3 players I think would be very, very good for that role. But guess what? It's just 2 positions. Up front, we know we're going to need quick, pacey wingers, people who can create problems, also people who can do individual skill, who has individual skill set to take on a man and beat a man, because you are going to be playing on as an inverted winger, because with a 3-4-3 formation, it is likely that the center forward will come inside into the central area to provide an extra creative element. That's something that we might need. So we might see the likes of Liam Bailey over on the right-hand side, someone is quick, pacey, and can beat a man on the go. And over on the left-hand side, I think that Jamal Lowe is a good competitor. Jamal Lowe scores a lot of goals, so goal scoring is not an issue. We just need to get him in front of that goal. Now, one thing we do know that Mikel Antonio is a very, very competitive striker who leads the line and does a lot of defensive work. But on the essence of technical ability, he's not the most technical striker. Someone who will come in between the line and do the creative work. Yes, we do know that he can pass the ball. I'm not talking about passing. I'm talking about the midfield instinct. So even in a 3-4-3 formation, I think in that essence, the best striker would use for a system like that would actually be Andre Gray. Someone who can drop in between the lines, be a creative element, great with holding up the ball, and can release the strikers on the go. The wingers can release the inside forwards, which are Liam Bailey and Jamal Lowe, on the go, as we can see in the last game against the USA that he did. So those are the elements of playing a 3-4-3. Now let's move over to a different system. I'm just going to speak about 2 systems in particular, which is the same system as a 4-3-3 system, which I believe would overload the midfield area, keep us compact in the midfield area, adding an additional central midfielder, and also you have 1 central defensive midfielder. I would consider on the back line, we also think about players and how players are suited to play with other partnership. Now we can look at the right and the right back in the fullback position. We do know we have the experience of guys such as Mariapa, but for this time going around, we want fresh young legs, people we can think about moving the country going forward. Yes, we do know we have to pay respect to Mariapa because of his senior experience and how long he has been a member of the Reggae Boys team. But we also have to consider the longevity, what we want to do going forward. So for me, at right back, at the fullback position, I'm still looking at Wes Harden as a fullback, partner. And over at the left hand side, definitely it has to be Taxi. We know already who is the goalkeeper. You have a lot of goalkeepers. You have Amal Knight. You have Andre Blake, and also Jaden White. And these are just strong names. Dwayne Miller is still there as well. So we have a good abundance of quality goalkeepers. Now let's go into the centre back pairing, where I do think that pairing and partnership is pretty much really, really important, because we can't have the same similar type of defenders. We need someone who is rash. We need someone who's going to engage in those tackles, and someone who is a cool and calm-headed player. Now, we know the type of player that Damian Lowell is. He loves to engage the striker. He is dominant. He wants to get physical. He wants to get onto the defense, in defender. So, Liam Moore is the same, similar type of player who wants to get physical. So, pairing Liam Moore and Damian Lowell would be very, very difficult, because we'll end up with two strikers who will definitely try their best to engage the attackers. We're definitely going to need someone who's be cool, calm, and headed, and also keep the defense line structured. So we're looking at maybe a Damian Lowe and an Ethan Pinnock. Ethan Pinnock, calm, under pressure, and also someone who does not dive into tackles and rush into tackles. We need someone like that. But we know that Damian Lowe and Liam Moore are the type of players that will go and engage the strikers and stop the attack as early as possible. So we need a calm-headed player, also with someone who's eager to go out there and create and make the first tackle, which would be Damian Lowe and Liam Moore, and also Ethan Pinnock as that defensive element. Now, in the midfield area for this formation, we need one central defensive midfielder, someone who can hold the line. Because at this moment, there's no confirmation about Lewis Baker, which I do think he can dominate this position. I am looking at Kevin Lambert, tall, physical structure, do a lot of defensive work, clean up, very, very aggressive in the tackle. I'm looking at Kevin Lambert, and two box-to-box midfielder. I'm also looking at Daniel Johnson, Casey Palmer. The reason why I consider both of them is because we need someone. Casey Palmer is more of an attacking-minded player, but we also have to consider the effects of Daniel Johnson. He's a box-to-box midfielder, someone who can also provide defensive support for Lambert when the game is a bit rough. And we do know that Daniel Johnson himself can also play in that defensive structure, but the higher he goes up the pitch, the more dangerous he becomes. So I'm looking at Daniel Johnson and also Casey Palmer as the two box-to-box number 8, and also Kevin Lambert as the number 6, number 4, who is going to protect the defensive line. In front of them, now the attacking three, this year we don't need an attacker, we don't need a striker to come back in the deep position to be an extra creative element. We need someone who is a fox in the box, and also we need two wingers, natural wingers, people who are going to go down to the byline and get that ball in and crosses, and also people are going to cut inside, and also players inverted wingers. And same said, we are still looking at Jamal Lowe and Liam Billing. It is so good that these two players are so versatile that they can play in multiple systems. But it still have to consider that we can also see Liam Billing and Bobby Reid in those two positions. Yes, we know we can consider Bobby Reid as also a central, put him in a central midfield area, but we're still not sure. But Bobby Reid would be preferably play as the attacking midfielder. Also, in the 3-5-2 formation, Bobby Reid will still be a good wing back option as well, because we have seen him deploy in that position quite so often. But up front, leading line would have to be Mikel Antonio for this formation, because we need a fox in the box, someone who is dangerous inside of the box, who will bully defenders, because playing a 4-3-3 formation, it's expected, I'm not saying it will, it's expected that you will dominate a bit of the position and also push the team defense line a bit deeper into their own half. Then now you have the likes of Mikel Antonio creating an extra dangerous element inside of the 18-yard box with incoming runners on the wing, such as Jamal Lowe, Bobby Reid, or Leon Bailey. Then now Daniel Johnson and Casey Palmer on the top of the box and protecting and shielding the back four. We have the likes of Kevin Lambert. Then now we can still also add extra element of the two fullbacks, Taxi and also Wes Harding, going down, bombing down the line, creating a different extra, that different attacking force, and also a different potentially goal scoring threat. So people, those are the few statistics and also the tactical insight that I would want to run through. So this has been the Reggae Boy tactical deployment and how we see the teams going forward. But people, thank you very much for tuning. Hopefully you guys smash the like button if you like the content. I know many of you will disagree with this. You guys are going to disagree with all so many things, but that is the reason why we do this show, because we want to get everyone insight and what they do think. If you believe I am wrong, if you see another system that will best suit this team, go and put it in the comment section and let me know about it. Thank you very much, people. Please remember to smash that like button. This is Military Guna TV. Guess what? I am out.